In this challenge, we start with a vertical lift conveyor system, and the goal is to design a control system for it. The packages are transported with a horizontal conveyor belt. They are then lifted up to a higher level by a vertical conveyor. We see that the packages arrive at the loading zone too quickly, causing accumulation and packages to fall off the forks. Now, in this problem, the vertical conveyor fork speed is fixed at 0.75 meters per second. However, we are free to control the horizontal conveyor belt and how quickly packages enter the belt. By measuring the distance between the forks, we conclude that just over 0.41 forks pass the loading point per second. So let's start there and place 0.41 packages per second onto the belt. Now there is no buildup and the packages are lifted without problem. However, this is for a particular point at which packages are placed onto the belt. So, let's move this point. Let's see that again. The package is lifted on its edge, causing it to fall off the fork. This is obviously a serious problem that we need to address. So let's create a cylinder that represents a laser that can detect if a risky lift is about to take place. This is our current code. Let's update it to make use of the laser. Now, when the laser detects a fork, the horizontal conveyor belt stops for 1 second, preventing packages from entering the vertical conveyor in a risky way. We now see that the horizontal belt stops to prevent dangerous lifts. However, the belt also stops when a package is far from the vertical conveyor, meaning that the horizontal belt stops more often than necessary. So let's add a second laser. Again, let's update our code. Now, when laser A detects a fork, a 1 second timer starts. If laser B detects a package within this time window, the belt is stopped. Now the belt does not stop when a package is far away. However, this is again for a particular point at which packages are placed on the belt. So let's randomize the rate at which packages are placed on the belt. This is effectively the same thing as randomizing the placement point. Let's update our code again. The rate at which packages are placed on the belt is now randomized to be between 0.25 and 1.5 packages per second. Let's see that again. What happened is that the code for our control system does not consider if the loading zone is empty or not, effectively assuming it is empty. So the second package was not stopped because if the loading zone had been empty, it would have been lifted up without problem. We need to address this. One way is to add a third laser at the loading zone that detects if the loading zone is empty or not. However, there is another way that only makes use of the two lasers we already have. Let's rewrite our code with the latter option. We now have two conditions under which the belt stops. The first condition is as before. The second condition is new. Now, when a package crosses laser B, a 1.5 second timer starts. If laser B detects another package within this time window, the belt is stopped. This new second condition is intended to stop the belt from trying to load a package to an already occupied loading zone. Now, the horizontal belt is not stopped unnecessarily, and packages are lifted in a safe way by the forks regardless of the rate at which they are placed on the belt.